to my channel. I'm sorry if you could hear music in the background. My mom is on her Dominican shit today and she's cleaning the house. So today I'm gonna be talking about how I wrecked my dad's new car. And this happened on the 3rd of January, so it was a few days ago. It was really not that long ago. And I'm not even sure I should be talking about it because of legal reasons, but so basically how it started was my dad wanted to show me his new car, which was a Honda sedan. And because his old car got problems, he got a new one. So he came over to show it to me, and then he took me to my sister's house. And we were just chilling in the living room. We were just talking, and then I went downstairs to show her the new car, and she didn't really like it. Like, she preferred the old one, but it was fine. And then we went back upstairs. So basically, I did not want to be home that day, especially that we got a new car, and like, I haven't driven in months because his old car wasn't working. So I was like, I was fiending to go out. I was like, can we go out? Can we go out? Can we do something? And she was just not with it. Like, she was being super boring, and she was just like, no, let's watch movies and let's just talk. Like, I don't feel like going out. And I was like, fine. So fast forward to when she did want to leave the crib, and we just wanted to go to the store and get some doves. So we took the car, and the store was 2 blocks away, and then we stopped in front of the store, and she's looking at me like, go in, get your stuff. And I'm like, I don't want nothing. And then she's like, well, we came here for you. And I was like, I don't want anything. Like, I never said I wanted anything. So because it was a Friday night, she was just like, well, I don't want to go home, like I said in the beginning. And we just drove around HP. If you don't know what HP is, it's Hunts Point here in the Bronx. And it's just where a bunch of people go and take their cars and they drink and smoke and stuff. But HP was not active that night. We just drove around to drive around because cars never drive. I spend whatever, girl, I do whatever to show you I'm serious. That's not familiar, they just talking shit because they feel inferior. Oh yeah. The music is so loud. So after about 30 minutes of driving around HP, she wanted to drive, so I let her drive. And we just went on the highways because I don't know why, but me and my sister love the highway because, especially at night, because you can drive quick. There's no, like, technically there's not really a speed limit. And when you're blasting music in the car, that shit's fun. So we just drove on the highway for a few, and then I looked at one of the signs and I realized that we were headed to co-op, and I was like, sis, you need to get off at the nearest exit and we need to go back home. So when I told her that we were headed to co-op, we looked at each other and we were laughing. And then at this time my dad was calling my phone because he was like, oh, I need to take you home because I need to change the gas for the oil tomorrow. Little did he know that's not the only thing he needed to change for the car. So after that, I was like, all right, we're on our way back. It took us about 20 minutes to get to the crib. So he kept calling my phone and I was like, we're on our way, relax. And then after that, she wanted to go to the store again. This is where the story gets interesting. So we're double parked and she goes in the stores and gets whatever she needs to get. And when she comes back outside, I'm like, we're good, we can leave. And she's like, yeah. So I was gonna head straight. I was not gonna turn, I was gonna head straight. You would think that would be easy, right? Apparently not. First of all, I checked in my rear view to see if anyone was coming because I was still in the double parked section, so I would have to like maneuver my way out either way. So I made sure no cars were coming. So I'm going straight, right? And all of a sudden I see this girl speeding past me, and you know the dotted line that like separates the two lanes? This girl had the nerve to cross the dotted line and hit me. So I guess she didn't want to wait for me to like go straight. So she was trying to like go past me, and while she was doing that, she crossed the double line and she hit me, and I started panicking. So some of y'all must be thinking like, why are you panicking? It wasn't your fault. I've never been in a car accident. I've never been in an accident in general. So the fact that I was the one driving, that it was nighttime, I was already freaking out. I was like, no, there's no way that this is my life. And that week was already so hard for me. So the fact that this happened, I was like, this is amazing. I'm not gonna cap. I really wanted to do a hit and run. Like, I really just wanted to bolt out of there. But my sister was like, relax, just pull over, it's fine. And my heart was beating so fast because like I genuinely like didn't know what to do. So I boom, I park, right? Bro, oh, this part gets me so upset. Right when, like, because she kept going. She didn't stop until, like, she was, like, a few feet away from me. Why, when she stops the car, the first thing I see is that her daughter is literally coming out the car recording me. I'm like, nah, they looking for money. They did this shit on purpose. This was a setup. So I really felt bad. Like, I wanted to apologize to the family, but I'm like, what am I apologizing for? You crossed the dotted line. Like, this shit was not my fault. You should apologize to me. And then I look down on my leg and I have a deep cut on my right leg. And I'm like, how the hell if the door is on my left side? So we got out the car and my sister goes up to her car and she's like, you know, is everyone okay? Is everyone good? And they're like, well, she was like, well, my daughter's neck hurts. My son's back hurts. My dad can't walk. Like, she was doing the absolute most. I was like, there's no way that this was not a setup. Like, there's absolutely no way. So this is very important. Because we were gonna do a store run initially in the very beginning of the story when I told you guys that, my sister never grabbed her wallet, which has her license inside. So the only thing we were driving with was my permit, and that was not good. So my sister sends me to go back to her house, which is only 2 blocks away, and she's like, get my wallet, just get my wallet, because it has everything inside. So my sister never gave me keys because she lives in an apartment, so she never gave me the keys to open the door because she lost her keys. So in my head, I'm thinking like, how am I gonna like get upstairs? So I start yelling at the window that my sister's room is at to get like my niece's attention so she can come downstairs and open the door. I kid you not, I was there for 12 minutes yelling my niece's name to come downstairs and open the door, and I'm guessing she fell asleep, and I didn't get no one's attention, and I'm out here panicking for my life because I'm like, I'm gonna get locked up. This is gonna be on my permanent record. Like, there's no way. While all this is happening, my dad is blowing up my phone because he needs to change the oil tomorrow. That's funny because there's a lot of things you need to change with the car now. I forgot to mention that when she crashed into me, my dad's rim came off. The headlight was like blinking on and off, and there were a lot of scratches in the car, like on the car in the front. It didn't look good. I said my dad was blowing on my phone. Like, I got like 10 missed calls from him, and my phone was on 15%, and I was like, ugh. I was so stressed out. I ended up answering one of his calls and I yelled at him. I was like, please give me 5 minutes, like, I'm stressed out right now. He was like, what happened? I'm like, just give me 5 minutes, that's all I need. After I hung up the phone, he didn't call me back for like another hour, which I was so thankful about, because that would have like stressed me out even more. So I go back to the crime scene. Honestly, the way this girl dragged it, you would have thought I killed somebody. Bro, she called so many ambulances and so many policemen, like, it was crazy. But we're gonna get to that part. So I go back to where my sister's at, and she's looking at me empty-handed because I couldn't get in the building. And I'm like, this girl didn't open the door, like, I think she's sleeping. And at this point, we were both panicking. And she was like, everything's good. She said she's not gonna call the cops. That was big hap. But you know me, I'm naive. So I'm like, everything's good, everything's great. I'm not gonna get in trouble. I'm not gonna get locked up. This is not gonna be on my permanent record. I'm good. Like, everything's great. So then I see her husband comes with her mother, I guess. And he comes out the car in a badge. So I'm like, this is amazing. He's a cop. This is amazing. So he comes up to us and he's basically asking us what happened, and we tell him what happened. They end up wanting to call the police because they want to write a report, which is super, like, I get it, but the situation was dragged really out of proportion. So my dad is still blowing up my phone after about an hour, and I'm telling my sister, I'm like, we gotta just tell him. And she's like, we'll deal with this on our own, and if we can't, then we'll tell him. I'm like, he's gonna know anyways. Do you see his car? I'm gonna insert pictures. But like, bro, it was so bad. So after we're trying to find cars for the paper because they want cars for the papers. I've never dealt with this before. I don't know like why they wanted all this, but they did. So I was trying to find the cars for the papers. the cars to the papers for the cars. I'm such an idiot. I was trying to find the papers to the car and I couldn't. So when he called me, I was like, listen, Poppy, I crashed the car, but it was not my fault and it's not as bad as it sounds. And like I said that before he could even yell at me. And then he was like, where are you? And I knew like in his tone he was drunk. I was like, this is not gonna be good. So my dad pulled up in the Benz. He hopped out the car like a fucking pimp, I'm gonna tell you that right now. But you could see in his face he was pissed. And I'm like trying to hide in the car. Like, I do not want to talk to him right now. And then he comes up to me, he's asking what happened. And my sister ends up telling him what happened. And then the girl's wife comes over and he's talking to my dad about everything. And the way my dad wanted to go about it was that he wanted to take the blame for me. Like, he wanted to tell the police that he was the one driving. I get it though, like as a parent you never want your kids to go through some shit like that, so it was reasonable. But the guy didn't want that, as I expected, and they end up calling the police. So the accident happened at 8:30. The police showed up 2 hours later and it was the wrong precinct as that, so they had to like send a new police car out from the right precinct. It was a bunch of shit, bro. So it's about 11 and the police, the right precinct, shows up and they're asking what happened and who was driving, and I said me. And because I was the one driving and I'm underage, their attention was mostly on me and my dad was not having it. Girl ended up calling 3 ambulances for her family and I was so shocked because they acted like, I don't even know how to explain it. Like, they acted like if the hit was really big and everybody was injured. Nobody was injured. They just wanted to make money off the thing. The police had asked me, are you drinking? Like, were you drinking tonight? Like, you know, regular questions. And I kept saying no. And they kept saying, I'm gonna ask you one more time. They said, I'm gonna ask you one more time, like 4 times. And I kept saying no, 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 because I wasn't drinking. And it wasn't even my fault. Like, why are you trying to, like, what? Then he lied and said that, so why can I smell it on you, like alcohol? And I said, I don't know, I wasn't drinking. Like, and they do that to see if like you're lying, see if you'll confess. Like, they lie to like catch you in a lie. It's, they were being dickheads that night and I didn't know why, because like nothing was like necessary. Everything was blown out of proportion. I should have done a hit and run like I wanted to. Because they don't believe that I was not drinking, they asked me to like blow into a tube to take an alcohol test, and if it goes above 0.8, then I don't know what would have happened. Like, they probably would have taken me down to the precinct or some shit. But I took the test and like I said, I wasn't drinking, so I passed. Then, oh, so before that, I had missed a big step, my fault. So before that, they asked for my permit. And I'm looking at my pockets and stuff and I'm like, oh no way, I think I lost my permit. This is the worst time that you can possibly lose a permit, especially if you got in an accident and you were the one driving. So what had happened was, when everything happened and she crashed into me and I had a big cut on my leg that I have to show you guys, I'm gonna put the picture right here. My permit fell out of my sweater because I was only wearing a sweater that night and fell under the car seat. I told him just that. Like I said, it fell under the car seat and I couldn't find it. Like, I couldn't physically find it, but I knew I stepped out the house in it because I found it later on that night when I went home. It was under the car seat. He ended up giving me a ticket. I'm gonna show it to you guys because this is, my life is fucking crazy. I don't think you guys can see it that much. And there's a lot of personal information in there. But basically, he gave me a ticket for driving unlicensed. It says unlicensed operator. That's cap. Because I told him where it was at. It was on me. It was in the car. It's a plead guilty or not guilty ticket. So I'm obviously going to plead not guilty. And I'm going to have to go to court for that later this week. It's amazing. My mom just came in telling me she finished cooking, so I'm about to make this as quick as possible because I'm starving. Literally, her whole family drove away in an ambulance. Like, each one got their own ambulance. They took a family trip to the hospital, bro. Like, that whole situation got me upset because how your daughter comes out the car recording me, but her back hurts. Wow. So he ends up asking to take a picture of me with my ticket, because when he asks for my name and my birthday, my zip code and all that stuff, to like look if I really did have a New York City permit in the system, it didn't pop up, which I don't know why, I don't know how, because I really do have one. I'm showing it to you guys. You see, I have one New York City permit. So I really do have a permit. So he gave me a ticket for that. And then when I asked him what the when I asked him what the ticket was for, or like how much it was or stuff, he literally said the opposite of what was on here. He said he gave me a ticket for driving past 9. The accident happened at 8:30 and you guys showed up 4 hours later. That is not my fault that the time doesn't correlate with your guys' time. Also, here you said that I was driving without a permit, so pick one. Pick one, because you're not gonna give me 2 tickets at that. After all that happened, we're allowed to leave. I end up finding my freaking permit at 2 a.m. under the car seat. My dad is still pissed, like, obviously. I'm currently still going through some legal stuff, so that's why I didn't put too much information in this video, but I really hope you guys liked it. Court should be fun. Maybe I should like vlog my court day. Like, oh my god, hey guys, welcome to my vlog. I'm in court. That'll be fun. I might actually do that to be petty. But I do hope that you guys enjoyed the video, and I hope it was interesting, and I hope it was comical. Because now that I look back at it, it's funny. Like, I laugh at it now. So I hope you guys got a laugh out of it. You guys should subscribe, like, and comment, and follow me on Instagram and Snapchat. I don't really use Twitter. And all that will be in the description box below. Bye, guys.